Speaking of safety, we're talking food safety this morning.
Best Buy before March 21st, 09, Quaker
right.
Oats.
That stuff is safe.
So it says. Born on, or not born on dating, that's a beer commercial. Anyway, expiration dates. Right. How effective are they? Do they work? This morning we're joined by Kelly McCoy. You are a food, what is your official title here? Sacramento's Environmental Management Department. You're a food inspector.
Right.
You're one of the people behind the red, yellow, green placard system. But mm-hmm. How effective are the dates or expiration dates on products such as these?
Well, there's a lot of Best Buy dates, and those really are based on food quality. But if there's mm-hmm. an expiration date, you definitely don't want to go past the expiration date.
Okay, so what are some of the things that we have in our cupboard that you would say you might want to take a second look at?
Well, obviously, if you have any kind of dented can or any kind of swollen can, you absolutely want to...
Why is that?
Well, because there could be an opportunity for botulism to grow.
Yeah.
Okay. So, and that, of course, on most cases is fatal. So we definitely want to, you know, throw these types of items out. So any kind of dented cans, you can either take it back to the store or just go ahead and throw it away.
Okay. It's damaged food out. That mm-hmm. seems common sense, but what else?
Well, basically you want to make sure that particularly things like deli meats, hot dogs, once they're opened, you don't want to have them be in the refrigerator longer than 7 days for Listeria and different kinds of bacteria that might grow.
My mom always told me, and I have a feeling I know where this is going to head, but she always told me that they're extra generous with some of those dates, you know, like to be extra mm-hmm. careful, and that was how she would get us to go ahead and eat some of the stuff that had slightly expired.
Right.
Bad idea?
Well, it depends really on what the product is. Really, if it's an expiration date, you should throw it away by that date. If it's a pull date for milk or something like that, you can go a week past that.
I'm really having flashbacks of when I was single. You know, you're like, I'll risk it anyway. You know, when you'd have a condiment for dinner. But which is completely different. So also, some of this stuff, like, you know, so what you're saying is, like, for the milk here, January 14th, that's sell-by. You know, you could take it a couple of days past that.
Absolutely. You could go to the 21st on that
okay.
and use that safely. And once again, if you go past that, the milk has a good indicator to let you know when it's bad.
Yeah,
it curdles.
You know when it's bad. What
right.
about, like, things like sugar and other things you might use for baking?
Decades,
I never really
right?
thought about
that. Right.
Like,
yeah, that stuff lasts a long time. Once again, well, particularly with flour, though, we do want to be careful because the weevil larvae. So you don't want to have too hot of an environment to hatch those little bugs out because mm-hmm. then the moths will come flying out. But regarding sugar and things like that, it's really about food quality. It's not a food safety risk. So you can keep it for a long time, but, you know, the
what
product
do you,
deteriorates.
What do you consider to be a long time? Like if I buy it today, if I pull it out a year from now, is that still good?
Yeah. Yeah, I would say.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Might not be as fresh as, obviously, once you open it, though, then particularly with brown sugar, it dries out and things like that.
Deirdre asked you earlier, and I'm going to ask you on camera now, as a food inspector, can you ever turn it off when you go out to eat?
Not really,
yeah.
No.
Yeah,
we're always on the job.
All right. Remember, the red, yellow, green turned 1 year. Congratulations mm-hmm. on that program
Thank
so
you.
Far. Very successful. All right, Kelly McCoy, we appreciate it. Food specialist. All right, we'll be right back after break.